Hello there, this is Gary Short with Gibraltar Software. Welcome to this latest episode in our video series. Today I'm going to show you how to get started with Loop Server. Firstly, as you can see, I've got an application here which I've already prepared to send information to Loop. Notice the familiar calls to start and end session, as well as the use of the send session on exit property, which will ensure our short-running example application is not ignored by Loop. The first thing we need to do is to set up our application to be able to send information to Loop Server. In previous videos, we have done this using the wizard, which comes with Desktop Loop. However, because when using Loop Server, you may not always have Desktop Loop installed, in this video, we're going to use the NuGet package. To install the NuGet package, select the project, right-click and select Manage NuGet Packages. From the dialog, select Online and search for Loop. Select Gibraltar Loop Agent from the resulting packages and click Install. Installing the NuGet package, like using the wizard, creates a reference to the Gibraltar agent and Gibraltar packager. Unlike using the wizard, however, we are responsible for configuration. Configuration is done in the app.config file. Today we are going to be using three elements. The first of these is the packager element, where we will specify the destination email address. This will tell Loop where to route any email alerts that might be required. The second element that we're going to use is the publisher element, where we will specify the product name, application name, and application version number. Remember to give these attributes meaningful names. If you get confused by what should go in which attribute, think of product name as Office and application name as being Word or Excel. The last element we're going to use is the server element. The server element can be used in two ways. Firstly, if you're using your own server, you can specify the server attribute, adding the URL to your server. Secondly, if you wish to use our service, you specify the Use Gibraltar Service attribute and set it to true, followed by the customer name attribute, setting it to the value appropriate for your company. Lastly, you can specify the AutoSend Session attribute and set its value to true. This attribute does two things. The first is to ensure that any queued session information will be sent as soon as it's eligible, whether from a previous application run or due to a log file rolling over. The second is to implicitly set the Send Session on Exit option to true, which means the agent will attempt to use the packager to send the log file at the end of the session. Because of this behavior, you're pretty much always going to want to enable this attribute. For the purposes of this video, we'll be using our own server, so I'll comment out the last element. Before we run our application, it's worth going over when the session information will be sent to Loop. Information will be sent under the following circumstances. Firstly, when the application ends, providing auto-send sessions is enabled. Secondly, when the log file reaches 20 megabytes in size and rolls over. And lastly, when the log file rolls over after every 24 hours after application start. There are two error scenarios for sending the log file to Loop. You can incorporate code to send a file on an error, and if you want to send it on demand, you can call log.sendSession. Let us run our application now, before popping over to Loop Server to see what it shows us. On the dashboard, under the tutorial product name, we find our Loop Server application. Clicking on New Issues and then on Latest shows us the events we just sent over. At this point, we set about managing our issues. However, since I went over managing issues in a separate video, I don't intend to repeat myself here. But if you are interested, then you should hop over to the URL on screen now and take a look at the video. Looking at the list of latest events, you may be observant enough to notice that some of the events are missing. If you did, then well done. In fact, the information events are not included in Loop Server, as we are positioning this software as a tool for dealing with actionable events, and information, by its very nature, isn't actionable. Don't worry though, if you need to see the information events in context, you can click here on the Open Session button and Desktop Loop will open the session for your perusal. Well, that's it for this episode on getting started with Loop Server. Hope to catch you next time. Until then, goodbye.